Good morning, students. In the earlier classes, we have learned about the various concepts of trees and what are the basic terminologies associated with trees and what are the various types of trees. Now, in today's class, we will be studying about the tree traversals. Now, traversing means visiting all the nodes of the binary tree or any tree. Visiting all the nodes of the tree is termed as traversal. Now, the order in which I will visit is based on the methods. Now, what are the methods? The first method is pre-order. What does this word pre-order means? Pre-order means that at first, while traversing, that is while visiting all the nodes of the binary tree, at first we will place the root and then the left subchild or the left subtree and then the right subtree. So pre-order traversal means first the root will be traversed, then the left subtree will be traversed, then the right subtree will be traversed. The second method is in-order traversal. In-order traversal means that first the in-order means the root will be in between the left and the right subtrees. So the root is in between the left and the right subtrees. The third method is termed as post-order. Post-order means that the root will be at the last, that is post. So post-order, the root is placed as the last. And first, the left subtree of the tree is traversed, then the right subtree of the root is traversed, then last the root. So, if you notice carefully, this pre-order, in-order and post-order, these three type of traversals methods are named according to the location of the root in the traversal path. If the location of the root is at the first, that is first thing, then it is pre. If the location of the root is between the left and the right subtree, then it is in. If the location of the root is post, that is after left and right subtree, then it is referred to as the post order. So basically, visiting all the nodes of any tree is termed as traversal, and the order in which I will be visiting is based on three methods, and these are the three methods: post, pre-order, in-order and post-order. Now, let's take an example and try to solve or traverse our tree through these three methods. Now, we know that there are three parts of a binary tree. First part is the root, second part is the left subtree, and third part is the right subtree. Now, suppose I have this tree as an example. Now, in the pre-order traversal, it is said that the root will be at the first visited, then the left subtree and the right subtree. So, for this example, if I try to visit the root first, my root will be A. Fine. Then it is said that we will go to the left subtree. In pre-order traversal, root first is traversed, then we will go to the left subtree. Now, if I go to the left subtree of this root, so I have this entire tree, B, D, E, three nodes, right? Now, among these three nodes also, I will notice what? I will write the parent or the root first. So, among these three nodes, B, D, E, what is the root? The root will be B. So, I am writing B. Now, if I go and see that the left subtree of this B, right? Because it is said after the root, left and right. So, first after root A, left and right. So, in this left, I entered again and after this root B, left and right. So, left I traversed and wrote down D. Right I traversed and wrote down A. Now, if you notice, the left subtree of the root node A is completed. So, root node and the left subtree part is completed. Now, the remaining part is right subtree. Again, in this right subtree, I will first visit this one. and find out what is the node. So if I see this right subtree part consisting of C and F, C is the root, and now we know that first we will have to place the root. Then if I see the left subtree of tree, that is F, and if I see the right subtree of tree, there is nothing. See, C has got only one left child and there is no right child. Fine. So I have traversed all the nodes, and the pre-ordered traversal of this particular example is this. First A, B, D, E, C, F. So basically what we have done, we will first take the root and first we will write the root. Since in pre-order we know, first we write the root, then we visit the left part, then we visit the right part, right? So first we write down the root. In the root also, there will be a left subtree and there will be a right subtree. So under the root, I will be entering the left subtree. Again, in the smaller left subtree, I will be seeing that what are the left part and what are the right part. So I saw that under this subtree, under this left subtree of root node A, I have got another root, that is B. So I have written B first. Then I have got a left child, written left child. I have got a right child, written right child. And there are no more nodes to traverse. So my left subpart of this root node A is covered. Now I will go to the right subpart. Again in the right subpart, I will see in that right subpart what is the root node, what is the left root, left subtree, and what is the right subtree. So in this subpart, I notice that C is the root. So I have written C. The left child is F and there is no right child, and also the left child doesn't have any more children. So this is the pre-ordered traversal of this particular example. Now we'll be doing the in-ordered traversal. Now, in in-ordered traversal, what did it say? In-ordered traversal said that the root will be at the middle. This will be the left part. There will be the right part. So the root will be at the middle. So fine. So, suppose in the middle, for this example, in the middle, I am writing the root node A. Fine. Then, for this root node A, here will be the left subtree parts and here will be the right subtree parts. Again, in the left subtree parts, the root node will be at the middle. So, root node B at the middle. Here will be the left part children, here will be the right part children. The left part children of B is D and the right part children of B is E. So my left subtree is finished, my root has come in the middle and here will be my right. Again in the right section, the root will be at the middle. So I have written the root at the middle. Here will be the left subtree part, here will be the right subtree part of this root node C. Then the left subtree part of root node is F and there is no right subtree part. So the in-order traversal of this example is this one. See, the root will be at the middle. So first I placed A in the middle. I left a space for writing the left subtree and therefore I left a space for writing the right subtree. Then there will be the left subtree part. Again in this left subtree part, the root will be at the middle, the left part and the right part. With this, the left part is finished. Again, for the right subtree part, the root will be at the middle, left part, right part. Root was middle, left part is F, no more right part, and hence the in-order traversal is this one for this particular tree. Now, we will be doing the post-order traversal. Fine. The post-order traversal of this particular example. Now, what did it say in post-order traversal? It says that the root will be at the last, first the left part, then the right part, then the root. So, my root A will be at the last, first step. First, there will be left part. So, in this is the left part of the root node A. And again, in this left part, there is a root, there is a left, there is a right. So within this left part also, it will be post order. So within this left part, the root is B. So the B will be at the last. before b will be the right, before the root is the right part, so right part of b is e. Before right part is the left part, so left part of b is d. So left subtree is finished. So after the left subtree, the right subtree, and inside the right subtree again the same post order will be followed, that the root will be at the last, the right will be before root, there is no such right part from c, and then the left part. So this, so d e b f c a, this is the post order traversal of this particular tree. Fine. So the thing is, whatever this formula is, when there are again left subtrees and right subtrees, whatever be the size of the tree, in those inside left subtrees and right subtrees also, the same rule will be followed. Fine. So let's take an example one more and try to understand this thing again. Let's take another example and try to find out the pre-order, in-order and post-order. So suppose this is an example of another tree. So suppose I am first finding the pre-order traversal of this particular tree. Now in pre-order, what does it say? It says the root will be at the first, then the left part, then the right part. Fine. So if I look at my tree, my root at first will be A. So A will be at the first position. Then suppose this position is for left subtree part and this position is for right subtree part, right? Now my left subtree is this part, right? With B, D, E, G, H, L, right? And in this left subtree part also, I need to find out what is my root, fine? So in this left subtree part, again I have the root as B. Fine. So I have written down the root as B. Then I will see the left subtree part and the right subtree part of this root B. If I go the left subtree part of this root B, again I have the root D. So I have written the root D. Fine. Then for this D, I will go the left subtree part and the right subtree part. So if I go to the left subtree part, I will have the node G. So I am writing down G. Now with this, the left subtree part of root D is finished. Now I will go to the right subtree part. Now for the right subtree part, again the root first, left part and then right part. The for this right subtree part of root node D, the root node is H. H will go first, then the left part. Left part of H there is nothing, and then the right part, that is L. So first H, then L. So the left subtree part, the root node D and the left subtree part of D and the right subtree part of D is finished. So with this, the left subtree part of the root node B is finished. So B, then the left subtree part, then the right subtree part of B. The right subtree part of B, there is only one element, so E. So that's it. With this, the entire left subtree part of root node A is visited. Now I will go in the right subtree part of root node A. And again in the right subtree part, I will go first root, then left, then right. So in the right subtree part, that is in this part, first the root. So the root is C. If you notice, we will go to the left part of C. But left part of C doesn't contain anything. So we will go to the right part of C. In this right part of C, again we will first write the root. This right part of C, the root is F, so the root is F. We will go to the left part of root. Left part of root is I, so first is I. We will go to the right part of root. Right part of root consists of two nodes. So between these two nodes, again the root will come first, then the right, that is, then the left, that is K. Then the right, that is no more element. And with this, F, I, J, K, this part is finished, this part is finished. So basically the root node left part is finished and the right part is finished. So the root, then the left, then the right. So this is the pre-ordered traversal of this particular example. Now we will see the in-order traversal for this particular example. Now in in-order we have studied that the root will be in the middle, the left part this side and the right part this side. So for this particular example, my first root is root node A. So A in the middle, this part will be right, left part, this part will be right part. Then for the left part of B, my first root node is B. So B in the middle, here the left part, here the right part. And the right part of B consists of only E. So I am putting first E. In his left part of B, D is the root. So D will be in the middle, this left part only G, and this side will be right part. And in this right part of D, H is the middle and L is the left. So L and H. Fine. Then for this right part of A, in this right part also, root node at middle, so C at middle, left part of C, right part of C. Left part of C, nothing is there. And right part of C, again, root node in the middle, so F is in middle. Left part of F, that is I, and right part of A. Again, in right part of F, J is the middle, so J is here. Left part of J is K, so before, right part of J is nothing, so this side is blank. So my in order traversal is G, D, L, H, B, E, A, C, I, F, K, G. Now I made a small mistake. The mistake is in my this part of my tree, the H is the root. So root H I have written in the middle, but L is in the right part of H. So L won't be over here, L will be here. So G, D, H, L, B, E, A, C, I, F, K, J. This is the traversal. Fine. I somehow mistakenly thought that L is in this part, but actually L is in the right part. So first the root, then the right part. In the previous thing I written L as the left child, but here L is the right child. So first the root, then the left right child. Now we will try to solve this example in post order method. Now what does happen in post order method? In post-order method, we know that the root is always at the last, first left subtree, then right subtree, then root. So for this entire tree, my A is the root, so my A will be at the last. This part will contain the left and this part will contain the right subtree of A. In this left subtree, that is over in this section, the root will be at the last. So for this left subtree, the root is B, so B as last. First is left of B, then right of B, then B at last. In this left of B, the D is the root. So, D is at the last. First the left of D, only G, no problem. Then the right of D. The right of D, H is also a root. So, H at the last. First the left of H, no nothing. Then the right of H, that is L. Fine. So this section is finished. So left part of B is finished. Then in the right part of B only E is there. So we put E. So the left and right part of this section finished. That is the left subtree of root node is finished. Now in the right subtree. Again in the right subtree the root will be at the last. So C at the last. Then again in there will be first the left part, then the right part. In the left part of C, nothing is there, so we will ignore. Then in the right part, first the root will be there, then the left part of root, then the right part of root. Left part of root is I. And the right part of root, again there is a root J. So first J will be there, I mean the last J will be there, then the left part of J and the right part of J. Left part of J is K, right part of J is nothing. So finally, this is the post order traversal. G, L, H, D, E, B, I, K, J, F, C, A. So this is all about the various tree traversal methods. That is in pre-order, in order and in post order. What are the ways and with two examples, one simple and one a bit complex. I tried to solve and make you understand. Now, students, remember one thing, that since it is the first class that we are understanding this tree traversal method, so it may seem a bit difficult for you to understand. So you do what? Take these two examples, and you already have my solved solution from these two examples for each of the traversal. Take these two examples, understand this thing, and try to solve it in your copy at home. Now, after doing this, check your results and tally with my result. I hope if you got it, you will be able to solve it. And if you didn't get it, try to do it again and try to understand what I have done. So, it may seem a bit difficult for you guys, I know, but still try it and practice it one time at hand in your home. Otherwise, it won't be possible for you to write the pre-order traversal or any of the traversals in one go. And still, if you have any issue, you can very well reach out to me. Okay, let's take the last example for today's class and try to solve it. Fine. So we have this graph as our example, and for this we will first out first the pre-order traversal, and we know for pre-order first the root, then the left part, then the right part. So for this tree, first the root is A, then the left part and then the right part. In this left part also, first we will write the root. So for this left part, the root is B, then the left part, then the left part, then the right part. So in the left part of B there is nothing, but in the right part of B there is D. Fine. With this, the left subtree of the root node A is finished. Then in the right subtree of the root node, in the right subtree, first we will write the root, then the left part, then the right part. So first we will write the root node C, then the left part, then the right part. In this left part also, that is in this part from E to L, this section also, first we will write the root, then the left part, then the right part. So first the root is E, then the left part of E, there is nothing, then in the right part. In the right part, the root is first F, then the left part of F and the right part. In the right part is nothing, so the left part only. In the left part, first the root is G, then the left part of G, that is H, then the right part of G, that is L. And with this, for this root node, the left part is finished and then the right part. But we see that from C there is no right part, so the right part is untouched. So my final answer is A, B, D, C, E, F, G, H and L. This is the pre-order traversal for this particular example. Now let's do the in-order traversal for this particular example. Now in order, we know the root will be at the middle left part and here the right part. So for this example, my root node is A. So suppose A will be at the middle. This section will consist of left part of A and this section will consist of right part of A. Now again in the left part of A, the root will be at the middle. So if I look at the left part of A, my root is B. So B at the middle. This section left part of B, this section right part of B. In the left part of B nothing is there, so only the right part of B. With this BDA, with this the left subtree of root node A is traversed. Now in the right subtree, again the root will be at the middle, left part and right part on either sides. So the root C will be at the middle. Here the left part, here the right part. Now from this example, I know that there is no right part of C. So right part of C I can leave it. So again in the left part of C, in the left part of C, the root will be at the middle, then the left part and the right part. So the root E will be at the middle, left part of E, right part of E. In the left part of E, nothing is there, so leave it. In the right part of E, the root will be at the middle, that is F will be at the middle, left part of A, right part of A. In the right part of A, nothing is there, so I am leaving it. In the left part of A, again the root will be at the middle, that is G will be at the middle, the left part of G, that is H, and the right part of G, that is L. So finally, after in order traversal, B, D, A, E, H, G, L, F, and C. This is the in order traversal for this particular example. Now we will study the post order traversal for this particular example. Now in post order we know first the left part, right part, and at last the root is there. So for this particular tree, suppose the root A is at the last. First the left part of root A, then the right part of root A, then the last the root A. Then again in this left part of root A, the root will be at the last. First the left part of B, nothing is there, then the right part of D, if B, that is D, is there. With this, the left part of the root node A is finished. Then in the right part, for this part C to L, first at the last will be the root, then the left part of the root, then the right part of the root. In the right part of the root, nothing is there, so no problem. In the left part of the root, in C, that is, first the root will be again there, so in the left part of the root is E. Before that E, the left part of E and the right part of E. In the left part of E, nothing is there. So, in the right part of E, that is from F to L, first, last will be the root, then the left part of the root and the right part of the root. In the right part of the root, nothing is there. So, in the left part of the root, we come from G, H, L. Again, in this left subtree of the root, first, the root will be at the last, that is G at the last, then the left part of G and the right part of G. So with this, finally we get the post order traversal for this particular tree example, that is D, B, H, L, G, F, E, C, A. So finally in today's class we learned about the three methods of tree traversals in binary tree, and using the three methods we have learned three examples. That is, at first we learned example 1, then we learned example 2, and the last we learned example 3. So please practice this at home with this. Now here we have the algorithms for writing the pre-order, in-order and post-order traversal. Now, for pre-order traversal, we know the root word as first, and then in there was left section, then there was right section, and in that left section again the pre-order was applied, and in the right section again the pre-order format was applied. So the first step is repeat steps 2 to 4 while the tree is not null. That is, till the tree is not becoming null, that is all the data elements are there. So one by one we will write and we will follow and the steps from 2 to 4. Now the first step was what? The first step in pre-order is to write down the root. So write tree data, and by tree data we mean that the root of the tree. Whatever data is at the root of the tree, we write that. So the first step is write the root, that is tree data. Then we will apply pre-order concept in again the left part of tree. Then we will apply pre-order concept in again the right part of tree. And these three sections, 2 to 4 steps, will go on in a loop until the tree is not null, or all the data elements or all the nodes have been traversed. So after all the nodes have been traversed, the tree has become null. There is no more nodes to traverse, then the end of the loop and finally end of the algorithm. So similarly in order concept, what is the there? First the left part, then the root, then the right part. So again we will repeat steps 2 to 4 while the tree is not part. First in order concept is applied on the left part. In the middle we write the root, and again in order concept is applied on the right part of the tree. These three sections will go on repeating up till the tree is not becoming empty, and end of loop and end of algorithm. Then in post order, what was the thing? First the left, then right, then root. So we will repeat steps 2 to 4. First post order is applied on left subtree, post order is applied on right subtree. Then we write the root of the tree, and this sections will go on in a loop while the tree is not becoming empty. And after the tree becomes empty, that is either the no more roots are left to traverse, then we have end of loop and end of algorithm. So if you are asked to write down in the example, write the algorithm for pre-order or in order or post order. So this is the algorithm part or the pseudocode part for pre-order, in order and post order.